Hi, this is Rich, and this is past life regression research. Okay? The idea is, will it be possible for me to give you the commands for a past life regression session on camera? And you pause the video, do the command, resume the video, do the command, like that. So it's research. I don't know if it's going to work or not, but here's how we're going to do it. And if you want to try it, go ahead and give it a try. I did an entity release session this way, and it worked. So let's see if this works. Okay. I've done some other videos on this past life regression stuff, and it'd probably be a good idea to listen to them, or watch the videos, to get a feel for what you're going to be doing. Okay. With that said, here are the commands, the steps, the procedure that I'm going to use. And after I give you these commands, the steps, procedures, I'm going to do a demonstration, an example, a pretend session. And I will ask myself the questions and I will answer the questions so you'll get a feel for what you do as the person coached. Okay? All right. If I look a little nervous, feel a little nervous, it's because I am. Coffee. Okay, here are the steps. The first thing I'm going to have you do, and I might have you do like this is, let me say this about the whole thing. When I ask you questions, I have to ask you a specific question about a specific time or a specific kind of incident. I can't do it generalized. I don't want to do it generalized because it's just too many variables involved. So it has to be a specific time, like a time you were in Lemuria, a time you were in Atlantis, a time when you were 10 years older than you are right now. I was thinking that might work because that couldn't possibly be this lifetime, right? Well, it could be a future time. Anyway, in this one, I think I'll do a time you were on a spacecraft, okay? Normally that will be in a past life, but it could be in a future life, a parallel world, alternate reality, whatever. But the point is, in this demonstration, in this research project, the point is to see if the process will actually work. Okay. Here's the commands and the procedure that I'm going to be using. It goes like this. First step is to locate or find the incident. Okay. Like, find a time you were on consider a time you were on a spacecraft. All right. And oftentimes, something it'll come to your attention just instantly. And so you always just take the first impression. Whatever pops up, go ahead and take it. Like, imagine a time you're riding in a stagecoach. You get a fast, you know how that works? You know, like, hey, don't think of a pink elephant, and you get pink elephant. It's like that. So, over the years, I think I'm going to start over. But over the years, what has been found out that the mind is so fast at offering up the proper data that you just say it and it's there. And what happens when things mess up is the analytical mind or the consciousness, the spirit gets in there and goes, no, that couldn't possibly be right. So the spirit can dismiss the first impression. And then start looking more logically in their history and in memory to find the past life incident. So we don't need to do that. It goes much faster and much simpler. Now, it's a little bit unreal to the person coached at first, but as the incident develops through the duration of the process, then, it becomes more real and more substantial and like that. Okay? So anyway, That's just a quickie on this. This is probably an outtake, but I might load it up as an outtake and start over. Okay, I'm going to end off now and redo this and cover the various steps and stages of this process so that you can do it online using a video as research. Okay? Talk to you later.